Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, into whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, whose never-failing providence ordereth all things, both in heaven and earth, we humbly beseech thee to put away from us all hurtful things and to give us those things which are profitable for us. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with thee in the unity of the Holy Ghost, art one God, world without end.
Amen.
The epistle is written in the 8th chapter of the epistle of Blessed Paul the Apostle to the Romans, beginning at the 12th verse. Brethren, we are debtors, not to the flesh, to live after the flesh. For if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. For ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if so be that we suffer with him, that we may also be glorified together. Here endeth the epistle. Be thou my strong rock and house of defense, that thou mayest save me. In thee, O Lord, have I put my trust. Let me never be put to confusion. Alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. The Holy Gospel is written in the 7th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, beginning at the 15th verse.
Glory be to thee, O Lord.
Jesus said unto his disciples, Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. Ye shall know them by their fruits. Do men gather grapes of thorns or figs of thistles? Even so, every good tree bringeth forth good fruit, but a corrupt tree bringeth forth evil fruit. A good tree cannot bring forth evil fruit, neither can a corrupt tree bring forth good fruit. Every tree that bringeth not forth good fruit is hewn down and cast into the fire. Wherefore, by their fruits ye shall know them. Not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven. Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost, the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. And the third day he rose again according to the scripture and ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The collect for today tells us very poignantly, I believe, that God's providence, the divine providence of God, orders all things in heaven and in earth. In fact, in the whole universe. And we ask him to put away hurtful things and to give us things that are profitable for our wholeness and really also our eternity. Now, I want to give you an example about, earthly example about things of providence, okay? Highway 179. Yeah, I know you're saying, oh, that bishop's really getting goofy today. Highway 179 is designed and structured and created for future eventualities, okay? And we have speed limits and roundabouts, and I remember when they first came around, I didn't understand any of that stuff. But they had a lot of bunch of stuff, and the total design was to keep people safe. That's the whole thing about highway design, to allow us, by following all the rules and knowing what we're doing when we're traveling down the highway of life, we can go from point A to point B and arrive there safely. That is a temporal example of the spiritual truth of divine providence. Divine providence is the governance of God by which he cares for us, directs us and all things everywhere, not only in Sedona, Arizona, but all of this magnificent world in which we live and the universe also. God is the creator of heaven and earth, and the universe is under his sovereign guidance. He governs creation as a loving father would, working all things for good, and the end result, which is total immersion in love, that is to say, the beatific vision, where we meet God face to face once again and forever. I suppose maybe you're thinking, well then, what about this? Why are some people in this world not doing what they ought to be doing? Why are they driving down the highway of hell instead of the safe path that God has given to us? Well, yeah, that's, you know what it's called. It's called things hurtful rather than things profitable. And some people live their life as if they're driving down the road of life. You know, have you ever encountered a wrong way driver? Yeah, I think you have. I have. Why do those things happen? Well, it's because of this magnificent gift that God gives to us. Although he's designed this so that we can be more whole every day that we live, there's something called free will. It's a blessing and a curse. And as declared in the epistle, we hear the contrary nature of what we can and cannot do, you know, flesh versus the spirit. And we also hear the truth of the matter of life in this world, fallen though it is at this time, in the gospel narrative when we hear about the false prophets. Now, why are people like that? Well, I think some are simply foolish, dumb. You know, they don't know any better. They're self-centered. And because they don't give a toot or a hoot about the grand scheme of life, they don't care about anybody else. They care only about wanting to make their own mark in this world. And really, it's not a mark. It's a stain, isn't it, when one acts that way? When we choose the spirit over the flesh, we are blessed in doing in accordance with the will of God. But there are also false prophets, wolves in sheep's clothing. And yet Jesus, even though he tells us of that dark truth, he tells us how to combat it. By their fruits ye shall know them. And so, a person, it doesn't matter who it is, but a person who is faking their faith in love is easily identified. And so since that is so easily identified in others, the question becomes for us, what are our fruits? Are they fruits of righteousness or of the world? Do they build up others, build up the church? Or are they works of iniquity, which tear away at the very fabric of what it is to be a child of God? See, what we're talking about is divine providence, huh? Ignatius of Antioch put it this way: we should really live as Christians and not merely have the name. How true, hmm? And so, this is what we're going to ponder this day. Are we driving the highway of life correctly? Or are we one of those dumb, drunk, self-centered, whatever, wrong way drivers? Christians do not bring forth works of iniquity. We can't, because we are so immersed in the love of God. And we get that way when we get God's love felt personally in our heart, mind, and soul. And then we just kind of spill over in the rest of the world and the rest of the people that know us. God's love, not our ineptitudes. You see, we are not designed to do works of iniquity. It is not God's will to do such things. And if we choose to act out in that way, we are not God's people. We cannot be God's person, but rather the world's. So what do? Well, our fruit, by their fruits ye shall know them. Our fruit is righteousness, and our King is Christ. Amen. We offer this holy sacrifice to the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, with a prayer that we may set aside things of the flesh and re-embrace things of the Spirit. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
Lord, receive this sacrifice to thy hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church.
Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all those who to confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
He who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ hath to all who truly turn to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right, so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. And in institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all evils, past, present, and to come. And at the intercession of all thy saints, grant peace favorably in our day, that we, being opened by the succor of thy mercy, may be both free from sin and safe from all disquietude, through the merits and mediation of Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, and the Holy Ghost, be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world.
Have
mercy. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world.
Have mercy.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather at the crumbs under thy table. But thou art the same, Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us.
Amen.
I receive the bread of heaven, call upon the name of the Lord, and it is my strength and salvation. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I'm not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Lord.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee. Preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Take and eat this in the remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. Amen. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee. Preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With us.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory be to thee, O Lord. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was a light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor the will of flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thanks be to God.